might be useful to go through the history of MoonDAO to understand where we are today. MoonDAO started as actually a joke. Like, we never intended it for it to become what it is today. I'm very proud of everything that we've accomplished so far. It's been a very wild journey, but you know, initially, what we wanted to do is to purchase the largest lunar asteroid. We literally called all of the biggest auction houses. We talked to world's experts on lunar asteroids and lunar regolith that we could purchase. And the joke was that you know, we were going to be the largest governing body of the largest chunk of the moon. And as a result, we would be able to circumvent the 1967 Outer Space Treaty that claims that there can be no national appropriation of the moon. In other words, that no nation can claim that they own property on the moon or own any piece of the moon. It actually, in a way, DAOs make a lot of sense when it comes to ownership of celestial bodies. It's something that's, you know, nation agnostic, and you know, a collective of friends from around the world. Well, that's not a nation, so maybe there's something there. As we started to look into that deeper, some people in our community had the idea of, hey, why don't we actually just send some of our members up into space? And then we started with the goal of sending one of our members up into space on actually a Virgin Galactic flight, because according to our research, that was the cheapest one. So we started out with an initial goal of raising $450,000 from the community to send someone up into space. And it got out of hand, honestly. Again, we were aiming just to raise $450,000, and then we ended up raising over 8 million in Ethereum from over 2,000 people from around the world. At that point, we realized, okay, well, we can actually purchase multiple tickets, and we can do even more sophisticated things in space. We can fund different research initiatives. We can, and this is sort of more the long-term vision, become an organization that creates public goods to set a foundation for a positive and decentralized future on the moon and eventually Mars, et cetera. We're a very special organization because we are sort of on the forefront of two major exponential curves. You know, you have the exponential curve of crypto and the network effects of that, which I think are relatively unstoppable and will continue to grow over time. And also you have the space economy. We started a Discord in end of November, early December 2021. And then by mid-December, we created the goal to send some of our members up into space. And then by 2022, so a year ago, we had raised 2,600 ETH. And then we immediately secured two tickets with Blue Origin. And one of those tickets we voted on with the community token. The winner was a YouTuber. The group is Dude Perfect. They're, I think, in the top 10 largest YouTubers by subscriber count. But we sent them into space. They recorded their experience. It was huge. Gotten, I think, over 20 million views at this point. But the other ticket, what we wanted to do is we wanted to open up access to as many people as possible, regardless of where they were in the world and regardless of their financial situation. So we hosted a sweepstakes, and we had free NFTs. So you don't have to pay any money, just gas to get the NFT. Then we did an on-chain selection. So we created our own custom contracts. We selected the person using a verifiably random function using Chainlink on-chain. You know, this is something that I think that we'll probably be doing multiple times. And so we can send our members up into space and then use the overflow of that to fund research initiatives and donations like we did to, we donated to a nonprofit called Open Lunar that has very similar values. In tandem with all of that, we also put together, you know, what I believe is one of the most or more sophisticated DAO governance models and incentive models. We were able to scale to nearly 12,000 people, and all of that in the course of a year. What I like to say is, you know, MoonDAO isn't a crypto company. It's a space organization that leverages the tools of crypto, which is a really important distinction. So we're leveraging basically the foundation of Ethereum, which has all of these values baked into it that make a lot of sense for an organization with the values that we have. So, for example, if we had incorporated just as a regular LLC, we wouldn't have been able to have people from all over the world participate in the way that they are right now. We have nearly 12,000 token holders, and a lot of them are all over the world. We have people in Asia, in Africa, in Europe, in South America, in the United States, Canada, really everywhere. And so with an organization that, you know, fundamentally has the mission to align a lot of people from around the world, the current banking system that we have today and all of the regulations around it preventing certain people from being in the same organization, it really is counterproductive to what we're trying to achieve. You know, on-chain, transparent, auditable organizations are actually even more legitimate sometimes than your average LLC, because you can see everything that's going on. So for example, MoonDAO, you can look at our treasury, you can see how much we have inside of our treasury, and then you can see in real time every transaction that we're making. So yeah, I think that we've had amazing gains because of the stack that we're built on top of. And I don't think that it would have been possible to do what we're doing if it weren't for the, you know, crypto or Ethereum ecosystem. I think that probably the major limitation at the moment is access to not just retail investment. So like, for example, we raise with over 2,000 people on a platform called Juicebox, but really allowing for institutional investors to get involved as well. And I think that when that happens, that it's going to be wild. And then in terms of like MoonDAO building, you know, our own rockets or something like that, I think that at the moment, as it stands, we don't have the technical capacity to do that. You know, I'm an engineer. We have a group of engineers inside of MoonDAO, really, really talented ones too, you know, PhDs, people that are extremely passionate about space and work on technical things. But, you know, we're still remote. We're just laying the foundation right now for that. And I am very optimistic of the team and the group that we have on the technical side, but I don't think that you're going to see us building rockets anytime soon. But is that possible on a longer time horizon? I think it's possible. It's definitely on the table. It's possible for MoonDAO to purchase, you know, a small aerospace company and then to help operate it or to have that as part of our resources. Maybe we can buy a small island and then operate out of that island. I don't know what the future of this entirely looks like because, you know, we are a DAO. And so what that means is that the decisions are made by the token holders. So ultimately, they can drive the ship and we have that feedback mechanism. And, you know, sometimes I don't even agree with the decisions, but the wider community wants to go in one direction or another direction. And, you know, we listen to that feedback and we move where the community wants us to go. So I can't predict the future, but I mean, I can give my ideas on where I think we should go. But ultimately, it's up to the token holders. What I see the long term of MoonDAO is basically a network of a bunch of different organizations and that are all under, I guess, this MoonDAO banner of mission-aligned people that all want to someday become multiplanetary and someday have a presence on the moon. And we have a bunch of different initiatives right now inside of the DAO that are really interesting. So for example, we're currently working on a proposal or in the early stages of ideation on a telecommunications network that could work on the moon as a relay. The idea is rather than, you know, I guess at the moment, you know, we have a bunch of ISPs here in the United States and it's extremely centralized. Those companies that really lay the foundation for the internet, they could, in theory, you know, do some pretty negative things. And so, you know, if on the fundamental, you know, communications stack, you have a centralized entity or a small group of companies that control that, then anything that you build on top of it is actually not going to be decentralized. Similar to, for example, like you have Apple's App Store, and Apple can actually, you know, remove apps from its App Store if it doesn't comply with whatever Apple wants them to do. So can you really have a decentralized app on the App Store? No, because Apple can just tell you to do this and then you have to do it. I think that it's very important that the sort of like foundation of especially communications and information should be a decentralized thing. So yeah, we're really excited about, you know, launching our first, you know, decentralized satellite and ensuring that at least one part of this of the stack that will be built on the moon will be decentralized. And then what that allows for is the propagation of Web3, of decentralized values to go into these other celestial bodies, which I think is really, really exciting. And they can build on top of the sort of like the fundamental layers that MoonDAO creates. I think that there's a lot of really interesting things and MoonDAO will win by creating a collaborative ecosystem where other organizations, other companies can build on top of what we're doing. And so that's what we're focused on right now, is just laying this foundation and then letting people win with us and build on top of us and make money for themselves and for us too. I'd say anyone who is, you know, dreamed of one day, you know, being an astronaut or is just in love with space in general, they'll find a community that shares those values and really loves space. And people that work at current aerospace companies and that have devoted their life to space, I think that if you're looking for a community of people that are like-minded, then definitely join. And, you know, in particular though, we're always looking for builders, for engineers, and we're really trying to cultivate a culture of people that you know, build things and like to create. What we're also trying to do is, you know, maybe there's people that would like to one day work in space, and we'd like to provide those opportunities to them. So provide opportunities for them to get involved with the construction of a satellite or opportunities to get involved with the construction of rockets or design of rockets. So ultimately, yeah, we really want to build a culture of like-minded people. And we think that, you know, at the end of the day, a DAO is its people. Just finding very quality contributors that love space. That's really what it's all about. And then from there, I think if you have a bunch of people that really just put their minds together and they work really hard to make something possible, you know, the sky's the limit, or, you know, the moon's the limit.